let's talk about Peng Block. Peng Block stands for pericapsular nerve group block. It was first described 1 year ago, approximately, by a Canadian team. This block is a plain block, and it benefits from the recent accurate description of the anterior hip joint innervation. This block is a plain block between a bone wall and a muscle wall. This targets articular branches of the anterior hip capsule. And in this paper, in this Princeps paper, that describes the technique, they use Peng Block for 5 cases of hip fracture in order to manage hip analgesia. And what they see, they have shown in their study that when they use Peng Block, pain decreases significantly. There is an important decrease in pain at rest and when you move the leg slightly. And it is a motor sparing block because they didn't observe quadriceps weakness after this block. It generated important big interest in the regional anesthesia community. But how does it work? First of all, we need to return to hip anatomy and hip innervation. Where are the nociceptors for the hip capsule? In this study, the authors showed in histological in a histological staining that the main fibers, sensitive fibers for the hip are located in the anterior part, on the anterior part of the hip capsule and on the superolateral part of the hip capsule. So then, let's talk about the anterior hip capsule innervation. The anterior hip capsule is innervated by branches from the femoral nerve block and from the obturator nerve block. The femoral nerve block gives high articular branches. They are called high articular branches because they leave the femoral nerve above the inguinal ligament. The femoral nerve gives also low articular branches to the anterior hip capsule, and these branches leaves the femoral nerve below the inguinal ligament. The obturator nerve also gives articular branches. After emerging from the obturator canal, it gives a branch to the articular to the hip capsule. And sometimes you have an accessory obturator nerve in about 1/3 of the patient in cadaveric studies. And this nerve runs over the bone of the pelvis, just close to the iliopubic eminence. So, after that, the question is where to inject our local anesthetic to block most of these articular branches. And there is an interesting region on the pelvis between the anteroinferior iliac spine laterally and the anteroinferior iliac spine laterally and the iliopubic eminence medially. And as you see, if you put your local anesthetic here, you have almost all these little sensitive branches that supplies the anterior hip capsule. And this is what Peng Block do. But as I said before, it is a plain block. So you need an anterior wall, an anterior barrier. And we have it with the muscle, with the iliopsoas muscle, and with the pectineus muscle. So now we have to put our probe on the right place and to insert the needle without damaging other structures. When you put your probe at the right place, you will have this image. And now you are familiar to the anatomic landmarks of the region. Here you have in depth the bony landmarks with two hills and one valley. Laterally we have the anterior inferior iliac spine, and medially you have the iliopubic eminence. Just above, we have the, just anterior to it, we have the iliopsoas muscle with a remarkable landmark, the psoas tendon in it, with this round shape. Superficially, you have the femoral nerve and femoral vessel, and this is the danger zone. You need to avoid this zone. When you put your needle to perform a pain block, you come from the lateral part of the probe in plane, and the aim of this block is to go on this bony valley, just here, and to have a local anesthetic spread under the tendon, lift the tendon anteriorly, and have a spread medially, because if you have here an accessory obturator nerve, it will be blocked by a medial spread. When you inject, you have to check that your local anesthetic doesn't go up to the femoral nerve, otherwise you will have a quadriceps weakness. And as I said, it is supposed to be a motor sparing block. Just a little video to see the movement of the psoas tendon as you inject your local anesthetic. You see here the bony landmarks, femoral artery, femoral nerve, and you have a movement, anterior movement of the psoas tendon as you inject. Okay. For the indication of pain block, because that is the point. I'm very annoying to discuss about this because the literature is very, very, very weak for the moment. We have no randomized controlled trial published. It will come soon. I'm sure we will have studies soon. But for the moment, it is very difficult to place this block in our pain management. Probably, we can use it as the first paper for hip fracture to manage preoperative, for example, preoperative pain, as you do a femoral nerve block usually. Or perhaps for hip arthroplasty, but we don't know for the moment. Perhaps in pediatric patients for congenital hip surgery. And many case reports has been reported, but it is only one case. We need more study to accurately precise the indication of pain block. Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Olivier. Now you can go to the live demo. I will have a lot of questions for the audience. And probably the first one will be to know exactly where to find the bony landmarks, because it seems very easy, but it's extremely difficult to find a good way to obtain the bony landmarks. And are you too proximal? Are you too distal? And to show exactly everything around this position. I go immediately with Olivier. Okay, for you, Olivier. So, perfect.
And you need a convex probe because it is a deep block and you need a large view. You start scanning in the inguinal crease, as you do for a usual femoral nerve block. You see here. Femoral nerve, it is a lateral part here, medial part here, deep, superficial. Here you have the femoral nerve, femoral artery, and femoral vein. After that, you move your probe caudally to find a curved line, a bony curved line, here. This is the femoral head. And you have understand that Peng block is just above the hip capsule. So we have to go up, we scan up, to reach the pelvis and to see two bony landmarks, the anterior inferior iliac spine laterally and the iliopubic eminence medially. Then what we can see here is muscle landmark. Here it is the iliopsoas muscle, pectineus muscle here medially, and you see in the iliopsoas muscle the psoas tendon, which is an important landmark for this block. Just above, femoral nerve, femoral artery, femoral vein. And as I said, you don't want your local anesthetic to spread here, and you don't want to puncture here with your needle. For the puncture, for the
so in fact, just yes. to see the body landmarks, you come just from the knee, the hip joint, and go straight on.
Yes.
Just putting, yes. Making the artery, the femoral artery, more or less in the middle of the screen.
Yes,
and just
sometime
1 to 2 centimeters
you
proximally.
Yes.
You will obtain immediately the body landmarks.
Sometimes you have to rotate a little bit your probe,
yeah.
To adjust the image,
yeah.
But you have to stay aligned with the superior ramus of the pubis to see those,
yeah.
Two bony landmarks. Okay?
Okay,
and sometimes you have to tilt your probe a little bit caudally to have a better image too,
and to see better
the tendon of the psoas muscle.
Okay.
Then, when you put your needle, you come from the lateral part of the probe in an in-plane approach, because out of plane there is a risk of femoral nerve damage.
Yes.
So you must do this block with an in-plane approach, and you come here from the lateral part, and you put your needle on the bone, on this little valley here.
Contact to the bone.
Contact to the bone. And then you start the injection. Normally, you want the spread of the local anesthetic to go laterally here and medially. Sometimes it is very difficult.
You can see it clearly?
Yeah, yes. When you are at the right place, you can see it. But sometimes the local anesthetic stays here in the lateral part of the tendon, because the tendon is very strong. So I have sometimes we put the needle, we redirect the needle just here on the medial part of the tendon to complete the plane block.
Is it sometimes difficult to inject?
Yes, for two reasons. Perhaps you are at the wrong place. If you are in the tendon, it is very hard to inject and it is painful.
So it's the wrong place.
Yes, it is the wrong place. And if you are in the remember, we are just above the hip capsule. So sometimes your needle is in the hip capsule ligament. It is very hard to inject too.
Okay.
And you need a medial spread, as I said, and you need to check that your local anesthetic doesn't go on the medial side, on the medial part of the iliopsoas muscle to reach the femoral nerve. Because femoral nerve is very close.
Is it direct to go or progressively? You
no,
can see the spread of local anesthetic going to the femoral nerve.
In my experience, it is a slow thing.
So you can,
yes.
Stop just,
yes.
Immediately,
yes.
When you see.
But if you see this spread, you probably you're not in the right plane, the
okay.
right place.
Okay.
Normally, you don't have probably you are little intramuscular injection. Okay.
So you have to be just in between the muscle and the bone.
Yes.
Not intramuscular injection.
No.
And just looking to the tendon is not sufficient. Your injection should be just under the muscle or just in between muscle and bone.
Yes. Mm. Absolutely. Absolutely.
Okay. So, thank you. Wonderful. Thank you, Olivier. So, this session is almost finished. About pain block, do you use it usually, regularly, every day in your daily practice? Or do you hesitate now after, because, you know, you begin a technique, you are very enthusiastic, and but after 3, 6 months, 1 year, do you continue using this block?
I have to admit that it is an interesting block. Yeah. Theoretically, when you study the innervation, it is a perfect block, yeah. A perfect plane block. But as IPAC, as other plane block, sometimes it is not as efficient as a real truncular block. But I have admitted that it is for the moment we use it regularly because we have nothing else for hip and surgery, hip exactly. replacement for the moment. Surgical infiltration, okay. Femoral nerve block is not so efficient. We don't have nothing.
Pain block is only
for analgesia.
Yes. For anesthesia,
yes.
Even if you add cutaneous lateral obturator,
yes.
etc.
Yes.
Stay and for analgesia.
Stay for analgesia, and it is only for hip capsule.
Yeah.
You don't have the skin, the muscle, etc.
So, thank you very much, Olivier, and thank you all for this session. Hope you will understand better knee and hip surgery, what kind of block to use. Once again, have a good end of meeting and see you later.